back pain is one of the leading causes of medical symptoms. To understand what causes that back pain is proved very challenging and is one of the reasons why we're not all that clever at treating it.
So my clinical area of interest and expertise is musculoskeletal imaging. There was a group within the university who are developing an algorithm for analysis of spinal MRI scans. Alongside degenerative disease, spinal cancer and metastases is an area which is quite often the reason why we do the spinal MRI scans. So we wanted to take that forward and see how well the algorithm can work and develop a tool that can help with interpretation of these scans.
The annotation systems that we got with machine learning is really good at showing very small changes because it literally goes from voxel, which is the fragment of the picture, to voxel. So it's dealing with things at a very precise level.
What we want to do is start bringing the algorithm into clinical practice to aid radiologists in their day-to-day practice. The way we train the algorithm is looking at sequential scans. So it has a large body of scans where it's seen how the patient initially presented, did the cancer get worse, once it got worse, did they have a complication. We have some qualitative ways of saying that, this patient has a large amount of cancer, they might have a risk of fracture, but actually being able to quantify that will help the surgeons and the oncologists that are treating them to be able to take sort of steps to prevent those complications from taking place.
Clinicians like me are used to looking at MRI scans, and so we will measure things. But to do it systematically takes a long time. A professor of radiology might take 40 minutes to score a lumbar MRI scan. Technology now that we have with automated annotation means that we can do that in a few seconds. So that means we can look at large data sets.
A big dilemma in back pain surgery is knowing which patients are going to benefit from what treatment. And at the moment, we don't really have a good way of knowing that. And it's about trying to work out, can we use big data, so not just imaging, but also their previous history, their age, gender, genetic information. Can you put all of that together to work out which patients are actually most going to benefit from a particular treatment?